In this video, I will show you how to use OpenAI to create a simple web search tool. So I can say who is the latest Pope. It's going to run the search. At the back end, it's going, this information is received by n8n. It does the web search using the OpenAI web search tool and returns the results to you. So here is the information. So to understand this, let's jump into OpenAI documentation on its API web search. Now, if you come to OpenAI API documentation, you look at the introduction and you read all this, you can see it tells you that the authentication is always bearer OpenAI API key. And it gives you, this is coil, it gives you the endpoint, it gives you this, right? But we want to be able to send a message and receive a response. So go to responses. Create a model response. You click on create a model response. You can see here, it tells you if you want a model to respond to you, this is how your request should be. Now, if you come to this other side, you're going to see if you want a text input, if you want image input, if you want web search, right? If you want file search, any type of API you want to do, it already gives you the coil request here. So let's select web search so that we're able to do that web search again. All you just need to do is copy this, right? Come back to n8n and just import it. So remove this and paste it. Import. So it has imported it for me. So all I just need to do is to replace my API key with that. I've already created the API key, so I will just paste it there. Again, don't worry about this API key. It has already been removed by the time this video is going live. So we'll paste the API key. Always ensure you have bearer space the API key. So this gives you the authorization. You can see, now if you look at the API documentation, it also tells you you require, for the request body, you require an input is required. So if you look at this place, the input is the query you're making. The query you're making, it requires that input. You can see the model is required, which is, this is GPT 4.1, right? So you have to specify the model. The others are optional. So every other thing is optional, but because we are doing the search, we are using the tool type web search preview, right? And you can see the authorization, bearer space, the open, it expects an API key. The content type is JSON. This is coil. Now it didn't put the post method, but most whenever you're sending a message to an LLM model, it's usually a post, because you are creating that message. They are generating a response for you, right? So they're creating something new, but you can see it here is a post. Then even when we imported it here, you can see it automatically changed the method to post. So I think we are good today here. Apart from change here to expression, let's make this more dynamic. Take this input, because we want that input to always come from, we want the input to always come from the chat model. So the dollar sign, see, from put quotes, put search, right? So the same thing, if we say, who is the latest Pope? Send it. You see, it comes here. It doesn't have the ability. It sends it to this HTTP request, which is OpenAI search. It returns the information. This processes it and summarizes the information before it sends it back to us. You can see the latest Pope, the 14th, right? So that gives you all that information. And you can also look at the latest logs here. You can see the first point it called is the OpenAI chat model to understand what that query is and who to send it to. It knew that, oh, this person is requesting for real-time information, which I don't have. It sends it to this HTTP request to go get the real-time information. After retrieving that information, it sends it back to the OpenAI chat model for it to summarize it and format it properly before sending it back to you.
We got the web search working, which means every time we post a question here, it's going to call the web search tool, which is basically an API request to search the web and return the results. And the API request is going through OpenAI web search. So another thing we can do to increase the capability of this is to add memory, so that each time you make that call, right, is able to remember what you guys discussed last. So I can add simple memory here. Click on this simple memory. Context window is how much of the context you want it to retain of your past interaction. So I usually like just leaving this as 20, but 5 is enough to test. Now, so we have the OpenAI chat model. We have memory, simple memory to remember the context of the data. Then we have the tool that makes the actual web search and returns that information. The next thing we'll need to do, right, just to give it a beautiful UI, because this is a chat message. This is used for testing within n8n. You can also you can replace this with Telegram, right? So you're sending this information via Telegram, or you can replace it with WhatsApp. You're sending that information with WhatsApp. But I want to do something different today, right? We want to have a nice GUI where you can send that information and using n8n. So if I open this chat message here, you can see the setting that says make chat publicly available, right? So I can turn this on, right? Once I turn it on, I have a URL that people can connect to and they are able to chat with this. So if, and you can see that here the authentication is none. You don't need any form of authentication. If you open here, you can ask people to sign in with username and password. You can require them to be logged into their n8n account, but in this particular case we are saying none, so no authentication. The initial message is, hi there, my name is Nathan, how can I assist you? We can change this. We can say, hi, my name is Nathan, I can help you search the web. I can help you search the web. Right, how can I help you today? So if I copy this URL, before you do that, you have to ensure that this is active. Okay, let's paste this URL and see what happens, and see what happens here. You can see what it gives you, right? So let's go back and make this public. Let's go back and make our workflow public. Now you can make calls to your production chat URL, right? Got it. So if I come back here and I send this, now I now have a nice GUI. Start a chat, we are here to help you 24/7. So you can see the message, hi there, my name is Nathan, I can help you search the web, how can I assist you today, right? So that's basically the public message we allowed to be here. You can see that this is basically what is showing you on that on this page. So from this place, I can just search the web. I can say who is the latest pope, right? So once I do that, it's going to go back, it's going to search, it's going to basically run this workflow, retrieve that information, but it's going to be sending that information to the UI. So this is basically the result. Who is the latest pope? You can type more questions. What is the best AI automation tool? Right. So it says UiPath, automation anywhere, Zapier. They didn't mention n8n anywhere. So what we can say, how about n8n? Great, it comes back with good documentation on the key features of n8n, open source, extensive integration, self-hosted options, etc. So this is like a very simple workflow for you to build a web search to expose it to a UI so that you can interact with it with a beautiful UI that comes with n8n. But you can integrate this to Lovable, right? Have a UI that was made on Lovable and integrate it with n8n. There are so many applications you can build around this. Thank you very much for watching this video and subscribe to get more videos like this. I would also suggest that you like so that YouTube can send this video to every other person that might find this very useful. Thank you very much and see you next time.